dear sisters and brothers, Jesus always gives us himself in the fullest. Today, after we see he had given food to the multitudes, and later they followed him looking for more food, then he took it as an opportunity to teach them about what it means to search for the kind of food that lasts. But now, here they are confused and they are asking, what kind of miracle can you give us so that we can believe in you? Today we are therefore invited that we should only look at Jesus. We believe in Jesus. We don't have to look at the miracles. We don't have to have miracles. But Jesus himself has fully given up himself to us, and let us believe. And for many times that we have failed to believe in Jesus, let us call to mind our sins as we celebrate this Eucharist. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me,
the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who open wide the gates of the heavenly kingdom to those reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, pour out on your servants an increase of the grace you have bestowed, that having been purged of all sins, they may lack nothing that in your kindness you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
From the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Stephen said to the people and the elders and the scribes, "You stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always resist the Holy Spirit. As your fathers did, so do you. Which of the prophets did not your fathers persecute? And they killed those who announced beforehand the coming of the righteous one, whom you have now betrayed and murdered. You who received the law as delivered by angels and did not keep it." Now, when they heard these things, they were enraged, and they ground their teeth against him. But he, full of the Holy Spirit, gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And he said, "Behold, I see the heavens opened, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they cried out with a loud voice, and stopped their ears, and rushed together upon him. Then they cast him out of the city, and stoned him. And the witnesses said, laid down their garments at the feet of a young man named Saul. And as they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." And when he had said this, he fell asleep, and Saul was consenting to his death. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
my stronghold to save me. For you are my rock, my stronghold. Lead me, guide me, for the sake of your name.
Alleluia.
Into your hands I commend my spirit. You redeem me, O Lord, O faithful God. As for me, I trust in the Lord. Let me be glad and rejoice in your mercy.
Alleluia.
Let your face shine on your servant. Save me in your merciful love. You hide them in the shelter of your presence, secure from human scheming.
Alleluia.
Kindly arise for the gospel proclamation.
Alleluia.
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 I am the bread of life, says the Lord. He who comes to me shall not hunger.
Alleluia.
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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, the people said to Jesus, "Then what sign do you do that we may see and believe you? What work do you perform?" Our fathers ate the manna in the wilderness. As it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Jesus then said to them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven. My father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." They said to him, "Lord, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall not hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. And then he knelt down and cried in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." Then he died. We get these words from the Acts of the Apostles, from chapter 7, verses 59 and verses 60. And these are the words of Stephen that we had from the first reading. My dear friends, today is Tuesday of the third week of Easter. I want to reflect with you today about the words that Stephen uttered at the end of his life, when he was being stoned to death. These words of Stephen remind us of exactly the very words of Jesus as he was being crucified, Jesus' last words. If we look at Luke chapter 23, verse 34, Jesus says, "Father, forgive them. They do not know what they are doing." And still, in Luke chapter 23, verse 46, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, and he says, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." What do we see in similarity at the death of both Jesus and Stephen? Of course, the writer of the Gospel of Luke is Luke himself, Luke the evangelist. And he's also at the same time the writer of the Acts of the Apostles. Jesus was condemned to death for blasphemy, and so does Stephen. The phrasal words they both utter at the end of their lives are similar. And what is not similar in their prayer? Jesus' prayer is directed to God the Father, as he says, "Father, forgive them." And also, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." And Stephen's words are, "Lord Jesus, receive my soul." And also, "Lord, do not hold the sin against them." Jesus is praying to God the Father. Stephen is praying to Lord Jesus Christ. But from both of them, we learn to keep praying for those who offend us. Indeed, this is not always easy to forgive those who offend us. Many times, we can say words of forgiveness many times, but deep down in our hearts, there is no forgiveness. We always harbor grudges. But these words that Stephen and Jesus mentioned at the end of their life were deeply from their heart. They didn't harbor any grudges. When Stephen prayed for those who killed him, those who stoned him, the words were deeply from his heart. "Father, forgive them. And Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." We also learn from both Jesus and Stephen how to surrender totally our lives to God. Jesus and Stephen had these prayers at the end of their lives. We do not have to wait till the end of our life to mention these words of surrender and also forgiveness. We are called to keep saying them every day. Indeed, Jesus and Stephen mentioned these words at the end when they were dying. You and I are called to keep every time repeat the same words. Every day, whenever I wake up, whenever I go to sleep, I'm called to surrender my life to God. And I say, "Into your hands, Lord, I commend my life." And in our day-to-day activities, every activity I do, we should know that every aspect of our life is God's. And we should always surrender every time, knowing that what we are and what we do is not our own, but God's. So it's very, very important that every time we say, we keep saying, "Into your hands, Lord, I commend my life." And then keep saying the words of forgiveness every time and again, and coming from our heart, just like Stephen and Jesus when they mentioned these words at the end of their lives. So, my dear brothers and sisters, let us pray in this Eucharistic celebration that may we have that virtue which should come deep down in our hearts, the virtue of forgiveness. Let us learn to forgive every time and again, and always commit our lives to Jesus every time and again. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Prayer to our Mother Mary to intercede for us against this corona pandemic. O Mary,
you always shine on our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. New salvation of God's people, know what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that as at Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother, we give it love.
Blessed are Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to lord you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb was slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, John Cardinal Joe our Bishop, and David Kamau his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, our spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be always with you.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Love of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Love of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take care of the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you enter the room, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
Jesus,
I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at this spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already here, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
believe that we shall also live with Christ. Alleluia. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may God Almighty bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go forth to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.